In Schedule 1, we saw that if supply is made without consideration, it is still taxable. So Schedule 1 says supply made without consideration, taxable. And Schedule 1 also says if related persons make this transaction, then even if there is no consideration, it is taxable, right? So Schedule 1 talks about related persons and it says if supply is made by related persons without consideration, it is taxable. And when we were talking about related persons, we specifically said that employer and employee are related persons. We said that employer and employee are related persons. So if employer makes any supply to employee, if employer makes some supply to employee without consideration, then what happens? That is, if employer is making any supply to employee for no consideration, what is the tax treatment? That is what we are going to learn in today's class. Now a question may come in your mind saying that when does an employer give something to employee without consideration? That is, under what occasions employer gives something to employee and takes nothing in return? It is more popularly called as gift. So in today's class, we will be learning about the GST treatment on gift by employer to employee. Now we need to understand what is the exact meaning of the word gift. The gift is not defined in your entire GST Act. The word gift is not defined. But in a common parlance, in a normal understanding, gift is something given in voluntary nature. Okay, so gift is voluntary in nature and not compulsory. So if employer gives something voluntary, that out of his own will if he is giving, that amounts to gift. On the other hand, if employee could demand it from the employer, then it is not gift. If employee could demand something from an employer on a contractual obligation, okay, there is a contract between employer and employee saying that employer will give this to employee, then it is not gift. Employer out of his own will voluntarily give something to the employee, it becomes gift. I hope you are clear with the word what exactly gift is. It is a common practice in a big companies that every year they give something called as corporate gifts. So big companies give something called as corporate gift to the employees. It may be as small as maybe a wristwatch, it may be a flask, or at times it may be as big as cars. Now GST says, the goods and services tax says, if you are giving something very small like say watch or some other flask kind items, the value of which is less than 50,000 rupees in a year, then there is no GST on that. So what are they saying? They are saying if companies are giving gift, the value of which is less than 50,000 rupees in a year, then there is no GST on that. But if it is more than 50,000 rupees, then there is GST. Say a company gave a car to the employee valuing 5 lakh rupees. Now company is giving car to the employee valuing 5 lakh, which is more than 50,000, then there is GST on that. But say company gave something very small, say a wristwatch valuing rupees 8,000 rupees. There is no GST on that. Why there is no GST on that? Because the value is less than 50,000 rupees. Now, how do you calculate this 50,000 rupees? Is it a one-time payment or the total of all the payment made in a year? They say this 50,000 is the aggregate value, that is the total of all the gift given in a year to an employee. Let us take a simple example to understand this. Say there is a company called as TCS. Okay, there is a TCS company which gives a gift to the employee. There is an employee called as Ram. So TCS is giving a gift to Ram worth rupees 30,000. The value of the gift is 30,000. Is there GST? There is no GST because the value is less than 50,000. In the same month, the TCS gives one more gift valuing again 30,000 rupees. Now the total gift value is 30,000 plus 30,000, it exceeds 50,000. So on entire 60,000 there is GST. Let us take one more example to understand it in a better way. Say there are two employees, Ram and Rahim. TCS gives gift of 40,000 to Ram and 40,000 to Rahim. Is there GST? Though the total value of gift is more than 50,000, total value is 80,000, is it given to only one employee? No. For one employee, what is the amount? 40,000, 40,000. So each employee value is less than 50,000. No GST on that. That is to sum up the entire thing, if a company gives a gift, the value of which is less than 50,000 rupees in an entire year for individual employees, then there is no GST on that. So if it exceeds 50,000 rupees, there is GST on that. Now let us talk about gift and contractual obligation. Gift and contractual obligation. Not everything which an employer gives free of cost is gift. Not everything which an employer gives free of cost is a gift. Say there was a contractual agreement at the time of joining of the company itself, saying that company will provide free accommodation, company will provide free food. So this was there at the time of joining for the employment itself, right? So there was a contractual obligation that the company had to provide these things for free. At this time, this does not amount to gift, right? So there was a contractual obligation that company had to provide this, hence it is outside the definition of gift. So to repeat the entire point again, gift is voluntary in nature, and if gift, the value of gift exceeds 50,000 rupees, there is GST. If the value of gift does not exceed 50,000, there is no GST. This 50,000 you calculate on an aggregate basis, that is total of the gift for an entire year. I hope the entire concept of gift by employer to employee is clear to you. Now let me ask you a question. Say if an employer sponsors flight tickets of employee to go to Switzerland. Say employer gave 2 flight tickets to his employee to go to Switzerland. The value of the ticket is 2 lakh rupees. Now tell me whether this attracts GST. Tell me whether this transaction, that employer giving flight tickets to employee free of cost, whether this attracts GST. To answer this, you need to see some facts. First thing is, whether the value is more than 50,000. Yes, the value of the ticket is more than 50,000, that is 2 lakh rupees. That is the first test. The second test you need to see is whether this is gift, whether this ticket is a gift or not. Say there was an agreement, there was an employment agreement between employee and employer, saying that employer will give one such ticket, like such tickets once in a year. There was a contractual agreement which said employer will give such tickets to employee at least once in a year. Then this is not a gift. Why it is not a gift? Because there is a contractual agreement. There is an employment agreement between employee and employer. In this case, this transaction does not attract GST. In short, if employer is giving anything to employee as related to contractual obligation, as related to employment agreement, there is no GST. If it is outside contractual obligation, then yes, there is GST on that.